Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Command in General, Second Marine Expeditionary Force, welcome to today's meeting, which Colonel Russell A. Sanborn will be brought to the rank of Brigadier General. Please rise for our national anthem and remain standing for honors to Lieutenant General John M. Paxton. From the Commandant of the Marine Corps to Brigadier General Select Russell A. Sanborn, United States Marine Corps. Authority to assume the title and wear the uniform of a Brigadier General, United States Marine Corps. By the authority vested in the Commandant of the Marine Corps, you are hereby authorized to assume the title and wear the uniform of a Brigadier General in the United States Marine Corps. This authorization recognizes the increased responsibilities bestowed upon you by the President of the United States and is deemed to be in the best interest of the United States Marine Corps and the United States Naval Service. This authorization is issued with the understanding that no pay, allowances, or entitlements as a Brigadier General will accrue until Brigadier General Russell A. Sanborn is actually promoted. Signed, Major General Salinas, Director, Manpower, United States Marine Corps.
Colonel Sanborn, it is customary before any promotion or frocking that an officer reaffirm his oath of office and then prepare to do so.
Yes, sir.
You raise your right hand and repeat after me. Aye, and insert your name.
Aye, President Howard Charles Sanborn.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
To support and defend.
To support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States of America.
The Constitution of the United States of America.
Against all enemies.
Against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
And to bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
To bear true faith and
and I take this obligation freely.
And I take this obligation freely
without any mental reservation,
without any mental reservation,
or purpose of evasion,
or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully,
and I will well and faithfully
discharge the duties
of the office upon which I'm about to enter.
Of the office of which I'm about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Brigadier General Sanborn.
Yeah.
obligation. The individual who is holding the bill. So congratulations and well deserved. Proud of you. Can everyone hear me without the mic?
You need the mic. Okay, we're good.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I think it is a tribute to Russell and to Linda that you're all here. Mark Twain, I'm thinking this is that building, but Mark Twain said, there's nothing that so influences the amount of people who show up at your funeral than the weather. Okay? Now, it's Friday before a long weekend, and look at the crowd. So this is a tribute to Russell and Linda. Congratulations. Honored to be here. I thank you for the honor and the privilege of presiding here at the ceremony. I look around the audience, a lot of great Marines, a lot of former bosses of yours who easily could have done this, so it's a privilege for me to do it. General Bratton, great to see you again, sir. Welcome back. Rusty, good to see you again. Ag, you're hiding out here somewhere. Good to see you again. So a lot of great Marines, a lot of great aviators, a lot of great AVAP drivers I've known for years and years down here. So it's good to have you all back in the family. This is a great day for Russell Sanborn. It's a great day for Russell and Linda and the Sanborn family. It's a great day for the Harrier community. It's a great day for Mag 14. It's a great day for Second Law. And it's an even better day for the future of the Marine Corps. So I'm just delighted to be a part of it, Russell. If Russell falls asleep, only half of it is because of my speaking ability. The other half is because he and Linda got in at 3:30 last night from dropping child number one off at induction in the United States Naval Academy. So we're happy for him and proud of both of you. So that's good. The other four are all here. Very good. Thanks. Okay, you know, Dad said you're next. Is that okay? Okay. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, what I'd like to do just a few minutes. Promotions are very special events in the life cycle of an individual Marine and for the Marine Corps. But they're special for two reasons. Number one is the performance. And you need to talk about the individual and his background. But number two, and more importantly, is the potential, what this signifies to the Marine Corps. In Russell Sanborn's case, both of them are equally significant. And many of you in the room from various stages and walks in life recognize you have served with Russell or have heard what he has done in the past. He has distinguished himself as an aviator. He has distinguished himself as a United States Marine. He has distinguished himself as a leader. And then in the process of 25, 26 years in the Marine Corps, he has done what you expect Marines to do. He's not only learned, then he has led, then he's turned and either taught or given back. So for a couple minutes, if you'll allow me, I just want to walk through his life. The reason I do this is not to take a lot of your time or to bore you, but so many of you know him from only a snapshot, from a 2 or 3 year tour there. Some of the immediate family know who he is and where he's been, but maybe not what he's done. Well, he's worn a uniform that hasn't been down into the land far to get him in trouble.
Amen.
Amen. And I've heard stories about that, too. I won't tell you anybody threw you under the bus, but you heard a lot of folk pumps last night. It was Russell Sanborn's name there. Russell, as you just heard me say, a native of the land Florida, and is indeed a member of the Deland Honor Society down there, and is a distinguished graduate of Deland High School. He wasn't there when he graduated 29 years ago. He is now, okay? But you had things that you had to do while you were in school. You had academic performance, which you certainly mastered. I can't comment fairly about how easily. But then there was this conduct piece that went with it, you know? And like Marines get proficiency in conduct marks, and we have all known Marines who are just 5-0, 5-0 on proficiency, but kind of like 1-9, 2-1 on conduct, you know? I won't go there, Russell. All right?